The next weekend brings the clash between Matt Wieman and Jordan Leavitt. Leavitt is... Alright, let's analyze Wieman first. Matt Wieman, right on score of 16-9 and 2 no contests. Got to say that this guy, 5'10", 67 inches is his reach. And I can say for Wieman that he is pretty much very well rounded mixed martial artist. He is really much long time UFC vet. The guy is in the UFC since the year 26. So, man, he kicked off at XFL and in UFC, four fights of the night against Thiago Tavares, Jim Miller, Sam Stout, Mac Dancic, and submission of the night against Paul Sass. Matt Wieman is a real veteran of this sport. The majority of his wins happened via unanimous decision or via submission. So, believe me, you don't want to go to the ground with this guy. He likes to drag opponents to the ground, but he is comfortable everywhere. Now he's going to meet the upcoming prospect, Jordan the Monkey King Leavitt. Leavitt is 5'11", he's reached 71 inches, which means he's going to have a massive reach advantage over Matt Wieman. He fights out of Las Vegas, Nevada. Jordan Leavitt won his UFC contract at Contender Series 2020, where he arm triangled Luke Flores. He is a submission specialist, a real, real submission specialist, BJJ expert with fabulous stamina. All of his wins came via the way of unanimous decision or a choke or a submission. So if the fight is dragged to the ground, I think Matt Wieman is going to get submitted. In the stand-up, Matt Wieman probably has some chances to win the fight. His cardio is better, but the problem is because Jordan Leavitt is very, very, very good. You know, very good on the ground. His takedown offense is very good. So I hope Wieman is going to put on a show. I hope it's going to be a good fight to watch. But Wieman lost to Luis Peña via TKO and Joe Saletsky. He is fighting for survival in the UFC. But unfortunately, I don't think he will be able to defeat Jordan Leavitt. I just think Jordan Leavitt is too big prospect at the moment. So, gonna say Jordan Leavitt wins this one.